Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. My name is Cindy and I'm an Australian homeschooler. Today I'm going to give you my thoughts on the Singapore maths curriculum. If you're thinking about using this for your homeschool, perhaps this video will be helpful for you. Singapore maths is available from levels 1 to 6. I've used levels 1 to 4, so my feedback will be based on my experience on those four levels today. Before we get started, it's important to note that there are many versions of Singapore maths out there. And if you've been doing some Googling, you might have discovered this for yourself. And now you're wondering, is there a difference between them? Are some better than others? Which one should I get? So there's a few. There's Primary Maths US Edition, which uses US measurements, spelling, and conventions. There's Standards Edition, which aligns with the Californian math standards. There's Common Core, which aligns to topics covered by the Common Core state standards in the US. And recently there's a new format called Dimensions Maths, which is considered to be the sequel to Primary Maths. If you're in Australia, you don't want any of those. What you're wanting is either the Primary Mathematics 3rd edition or the new Syllabus Primary Mathematics. And I'm going to show you the new Syllabus Primary Mathematics today. So this is one complete set of the level 4. Comes with one teacher's resource book. Comes with two workbooks, A and B for semester 1 and 2, and it comes with two textbooks. So I'll just show you how they all fit together. So we'll look first at 4A in the textbook. So this is lesson 1, counting to 100,000, so really looking at place value. So they've got an example question here. And it's telling you to count how many of each there are and what number do you get at the end. We'll now go to the workbook, to this corresponding chapter, and you'll see it's the exact same type of question, but now the student has an opportunity to practice that independently. This is the teacher's resource. So all the pages in the textbook and the workbook are duplicated and put in here. And this is some instructions for the teacher, some questions that you could ask your student, and suggestions for how you can explain each topic. You'll notice that each workbook page is here with the answers in there, so that's really helpful when you're correcting your student's work later on. Singapore Maths uses a mastery approach. And it uses a three-stage learning process: concrete, pictorial, and abstract. A mastery approach means you're studying each topic in depth and sequentially. There are cumulative review chapters, and that is really the only way to review previously learned units. Otherwise, once you're finished with, say, the fractions unit, you're not going to look at it again until next year. So depending on what sort of student you have, you may want to add in your own review so they don't completely forget the topic when they come to it again next year at a harder level. And with this curriculum, you pretty much hit the ground running, and there's an expectation that you have retained the previous year's knowledge. This is in contrast to a spiral approach, where you're constantly cycling through topics, coming back to them, and slowly building up your knowledge in each topic throughout the year. Saxon Maths is an example of spiral maths if you're interested in exploring that a bit further. Okay, so what does the three steps, concrete, pictorial, and abstract, mean? I might show you an example using the length unit in level 2A. So let me bring out that book. Okay, so in the concrete stage, students engage in hands-on learning experiences using physical objects, like a measuring tape or a ruler. Here they're asking you to find bits of furniture and items around the house and measure them. Are they less than 1 meter, more than 1 meter, about a meter, or more than 2 meters? When it comes to the pictorial stage, they'll be replacing physical objects with a pictorial representation. So instead of measuring a key, you're going to measure a picture of a key, or a picture of sunglasses, or a picture of a finger.
when you're moving on to the abstract stage, you'll be replacing pictures with symbols. For example, you've got string A, string B, string C. You've got language like straight line PQ, straight line ST, straight line MN. So that would be the abstract stage. Most units are then followed by word problems, mind workout, and a review. And that will be a full unit. So I might just quickly show you that for the length. So this is a mind workout. Most units end with this, which is kind of like a harder level problem solving puzzle type question using the concepts that you've learned during the chapter. And then you come to the review, going through all the information that you've already learned in that chapter. And then it goes to the next one, which is maths. The other defining features of Singapore maths is its use of number bonds and bar modelling. Let me show you what I mean by number bonds by looking at this book in level 1A. So I've got number bonds here. You've got 5, 2 and 3 make 5. I've got 2 pandas and 3 pandas. You've got 10, which can be broken up into 7 and 3. You'll then use number bonds with your subtraction and your addition. So here's an example of using the number bonds in an addition question. So we know that 12 is the same as 10 plus 2. So if you do 2 plus 4, so that's these two numbers equal 6, it's much easier to work out in your head what 10 plus 6 is. And this is number bonds in subtraction. So you've got 16 minus 5 here. They've broken up the 16 into 10 and 6. Now you can do 6 take away 5, which is 1, and you add that back onto your 10 to get your answer 11. And this helps with the mental maths, which is a big emphasis in Singapore maths. I'll show you what I mean by bar modelling in level 2B. Okay, so here's a question. Bala and Sam had 550 stamps altogether. Sam gave away 96 stamps and had 229 stamps left. So first, how many stamps did Sam have at first? And then how many stamps did Bala have? So when I'm looking at this question, I immediately think algebra. And then I think, isn't that a high school thing? Why are they expecting primary school students to do this? So with the Singapore curriculum, they introduce primary students to these sorts of questions and they use bar modelling to get the answer. So I'll show you what they mean. So you draw your bar and you put all the information from here onto this bar. So they have 550 stamps altogether. This represents Sam's stamps after he's given away 96. He's got 229 left. So you can work out A, how many stamps did Sam have? So you can add those two together, which gives you 325. Then you can work out how many stamps Bala had. So that will be 550, the full bar, take away 325, Sam's stamps, which gives you 225. I'll show you another bar modeling example from the level 4. All right, so this one, Kate had 5 times as many beads as Nora. Kate used 1,050 beads and Nora used 314 beads. They had the same number of beads left. How many beads did Kate have at first? So that again, I can work out using algebra pretty easily, but that's not what they're looking for here. So they want you to put all the information here into a bar model. So Kate had 5 times as many beads as Nora. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to represent Kate and 1 to represent Nora. After Kate used 1,050 beads, so Kate used a whole bunch of beads, and Nora used 314 beads, they had the same number of beads left. How many beads did Kate have at first? Well, with the information here, you can now work out what this section is. You know it's 1050 take away 314. So that's this section here, and it gives you 736. So now that you've got this, you can work out what one section is by dividing it by 4. That gives you 184. So that gives you how much Nora has. They want to know how much Kate has, so then you just multiply it by 5 to give you 920. And that's how you work out using a bar model. Okay, so let's have a look at the sequence and scope, and I'll again show you level 2, what they'll cover in 1 year. Okay, so you're covering numbers 1 to 1000, addition and subtraction within 1000, multiplication tables of 2, 5 and 10, dividing by 2, 5 and 10, multiplication tables of 3 and 4, dividing by 3 and 4, length and mass. In semester 2, you've got word problems, money, 2D shapes, 3D shapes, fractions, time, volume, and picture graphs. I have some comments about using Singapore Maths in Australia. So number one is the levelling. Singapore Maths tends to aim at a higher level than what we're used to in Australia. So if you have a student in third grade, I would recommend buying the second grade. If you have a student in fourth grade, I would recommend the third level, etc. Level 1 is pretty comparable, I think, but once you reach level 2, there's a big jump, and you'll notice that. The other thing is money, so I'll show you with this one. They use Singapore currency here, which isn't a big problem. Their denominations are pretty much the same, except that we use a $2 coin instead of a $2 note. You might want to get some maths manipulatives for your kids to learn more specifically the Australian currency. But it's not a problem at all to use the Singapore currency to do this maths. Okay, another thing to note is the multi-digit multiplication method that they use. So I'll take an example from level 4. You'll notice here that the method they teach, and they only teach one method in this curriculum, is the traditional long multiplication method. So that is you times your ones, you add a zero, and then you do your tens, and then you add them together. So this would be important to note if you're taking your kid out of mainstream schooling or you're wanting to transition your child back into a mainstream school. A lot of schools nowadays use the block method to multiply, so you might need to catch them up on both types. The lattice approach I think is also pretty popular. So those are my main thoughts on Singapore Maths. I feel like I've been talking for a while, so I'll wrap it up there. If I've missed anything or if you have a question, please go ahead and comment below. Thanks for watching!